Hello and welcome to the complete ethical hacking course, how to become a certified ethical hacker easily. My name is Mohamed Atef. I am an information security consultant and a senior penetration tester. With more than 20 years of experience managing information security and penetration testing projects, I am also one of the few Easy Counsel instructors. So all the ethical hacking course that I deliver them officially according to Easy Counsel methodology using their tools and techniques. I have many ethical hacking courses published and most of them are bestseller courses. And I'm proud to say that I help many students to clear their ethical hacking exam and become a certified ethical hacker from the first attempt. Now, let's talk about the CEH training. Certified ethical hackers, it's one of the very well-known ethical hacking training. During this training, you will learn how to scan, test, hack, and secure system. And system here is referring to any type of system. It could be a network, it could be a computer, single computer, it could be a wireless network, website, a smartphone. So when we are talking about system, it could be any one of those. And during this training, we're going to cover all those topics. This will be done through the use of hands-on labs. So everything that we will be explaining, it will be tested on a lab. And we're going to share this lab with you so you can download the lab and you can practice while we are doing that. So it's not just watching the video, but you will be doing that yourself step by step. Student also will learn how intruders escalate their privilege and what step can be taken to secure a system or their system. Now, by getting such skills and learning ethical hacking skills, this will not be enough. It's like you are learning, you know how to drive, but you don't have a license. So also the course will prepare you to pass the CEH exam from the first attempt and become a certified ethical hacker. The CEH certificate, it's a very well-known and recognized certificate from different entities inside and outside US. So by holding such certificate, this will add a value and a weight to your profile. Now let's talk about the course outline. What exactly will be covered and how in the CEH training? First, I'm going to guide you on how to build your own lab. So I'm going to guide you step by step on how to set up a virtual lab on your computer. And this lab will be a very realistic lab, in a sense that it will include all or most of the type of operating system. Windows 7, 8, 10, Windows Server 2008, 2012, 2003. So you're going to have variety of platform, Linux, Android. And this will simulate a real environment, because when you go to do any penetration testing or ethical hacking in any organization, this is what you'll be facing. That different people have different kind of platform and you need to do a penetration testing in such an environment. So we're going to teach you how to do that in different platforms so you'll get familiar with that. Once we completed set up the lab, then I'm going to take you to a tour into Linux operating system. Most of the ethical hacking tools that you're going to use during this training will be Linux based. And because some people may enroll in the course that don't have any background about Linux, so for those people, I created a section where you will be learning from scratch what you need to know to be able to use Linux in penetration testing. So you don't have to worry if this is new to you. I'm going to guide you from scratch how to use Linux and how to do a penetration testing and ethical hacking using Linux step by step. So it's like gaining a new skills of learning Linux as a new operating system. Once we are settled with the Linux and we feel comfortable using the Linux, we have a lab and we are okay with using the Linux, then we're going to move to the course itself. The first chapter will be an introduction to ethical hacking, where we'll be talking about some terminology. And this is the terminology used in the business, so you have to be aware of. You have to know what is a black box testing, a black box penetration testing, and white box. What is a vulnerability? What is an exploit? What is a black hat, white hat? So this is the only chapter that discusses the terminology. We will not have anything theoretical after that. Everything will be practicals and hands-on. Then we're going to move to the second chapter, which is footprinting and reconnaissance. This is the first phase in any ethical hacking, which is collecting information about your target using different websites and different intelligence tools. And I'm going to show you how to do that in a very effective way. Then we're going to talk about scanning the network and enumeration, which is also gathering information, but more technical information and in-depth information. Then we're going to move to system hacking. System hacking is focusing about the simplest way of hacking, which is a password hacking. But we're going to see that the password hacking, which many people believe it's not effective. No, it's very, very effective if you know how to use it the right way. So we're going to show you the proper way of using the system hacking or the password attacking or cracking technique that will give you an amazing results. Then we're going to move to malware, different type of malware and their threat and how they are created and the different type of malware and so on. Then we're going to talk about sniffing, which is a layer to attack. We're going to talk about how to hack a network. Network could be a wired or it could be a wireless or it could be a voice over IP network. We're going to see how effective we can attack a network and how hard is it to secure the network. Then we're going to move to the social engineering chapters, and social engineering also known as the non-IT attack. So in social engineering, you're going to see or you're going to learn how to do phishing, how to do fake website, how to send a fake email, fake SMS, fake mobile number. So you're going to see those techniques that will easily manipulate people, because people, you know, trust email blindly and trust mobile phone blind. If he got a phone from his bank, he will never suspect that this may be a fake caller, fake number. So we're going to see how it's done, and we're going to see very, very effective tool doing that. Then we're going to talk about denial of service, which is one of the attacks that affects the business very badly. So if someone launched a denial of service and crash your website or crash one of your server, and customer is not able to access your website to follow up with their business, this will affect any business badly. So we're going to talk about that, and we're going to see how it's done and how to prevent against it. Then we're going to talk about session hijacking. It's not really a big chapter. We're going to talk about the session hijacking with a couple of demonstrations, but we're going to see how it's done. Then we're going to talk about hacking web servers. And in this chapter, we're also going to cover things like working with exploitation. This is very high skills that we're going to learn during this course. Vulnerability and exploitation, and how to use Metasploit, and how to use Armitage. Those are the tools that allow you to work with exploitation and do not depend on the weakness of the user or that the user going to do something wrong that allow me to access the system. No, I will hack the system through a weakness, whatever security have, and it doesn't matter how secure or how intelligent the user is. He's not opening any link, he's not opening any mail, I will still be able to access his system, but from a weakness inside the system. This will be a fun chapters. Then we're going to talk about hacking web application and different web application vulnerability and how to hack them. And one of the web applications that attacks, that is because it's very common and very easy to implement and very hard to prevent, it's called SQL injection. That's why SQL injection, it's a separate chapter. It's one of the web applications attack, but because it's a very, very critical one, it has been excluded as a separate chapter. Then we're going to move to hacking wireless network. Everyone now is connected to hacking. I'm sorry, is connected to wireless. Most of the devices right now, new laptops, new smartphone, tablets, iPad, all of them can only be connected to the network through the wireless. They don't have a wired connection. And people do not know how easy it is to compromise the wireless network and to hack their devices. So we're going to see how it's done. And we're going to give some countermeasure to prevent against that. Then we're going to talk about hacking mobile platform. And we're going to see how to hack a mobile platform. And then we're going to talk about IDS and eventing IDS, firewall, honeypots. Those are the protection used and how hackers can bypass them. What is the IDS? How it can be bypassed? What is a firewall, honeypot, and how it works and how it can be bypassed? And then we're going to talk about cloud computing. It's a very small chapter as well. And finally, we're going to talk about cryptography, which is a very important skill to learn as an ethical hacker. So this will be the course outline. My objective will be not just to get you the ethical hacking skills that you need to be an outsourced ethical hacker or to work in any organization as a penetration tester or ethical hacker, but also to prepare you to get certified. So you'll be having the skills and also you have the license. We're going to follow easy counsel methodology, which is six phases: reconnaissance, scanning, enumeration, gaining access, maintaining access, and covering tracks. This is what we will be doing during the course. So get ready to become a real ethical hacker. And finally, some of the additional benefits you are getting by enrolling in this course. First, you're going to get a full functional lab with all the operating system and everything. Then you're going to get the full course material and the latest exam practice question, which is very important to help you pass the exam from the first attempt. Then you're going to get an attendance certificate that allow you to get 10 CPEs to maintain your certificate. And finally, you're going to get my full support. And for people who enrolled in any of my previous courses, they know how committed I am to any course. So you're going to get my full support until you achieve your goal. So I hope this course will be informative, and I hope that you are gaining the right skills and use them the right way.